Time for your six-month review, Mr. Hauser. Is there anything you'd like to say before we start? Very well. Do you understand why you are being held here? We'll take that as a no. You understand the meaning of criminal insanity? Do you regret the suffering you have caused your victims? I'll be back in a moment. You certainly won't repeat that mistake again. Mr. Hauser, shall we get this over with?
Terrible scandal.
I'd like to see what you'd look like if you hadn't slept for three nights.
Yeah, I bet you would.
Don't flatter yourself.
Well, at least your sleepless ordeal to rescue the ambassador's son was a success. That should help you rest easy.
Rest easy? I'm going to zombie land. I'm going to sleep on a plane for 6 hours, then on a beach for 6 days, then on the plane again for another 6 hours.
And Dallas said you wouldn't know what to do with yourself in Hawaii.
You still here?
Not for long. Nice tie, new.
You like it?
Oh, yeah. Bozo have a yard sale?
Oh! Got his sleep for 3 days, thinks he's a comedian.
Yeah, well, at least he doesn't stink.
What's that supposed to mean?
Your cigar.
This?
That.
Well, honey, this is a $20 Monte Cristo from the heart of Havana.
Mm-hmm. And this is a $600 original by Moroso. And after a day with you and that, it smells like the streets of Havana.
I love them.
I hate them.
Love or hate them, I've got fresh air waiting in Hawaii. And I'm late for a flight.
Late? You have 2 hours yet.
I don't want to miss my flight. And I can't find my glasses.
Greg, only time in his life he's worried about being on time is when he's leaving town.
This is Danielle.
Oh, by the way, son, you look awful.
So I've been told.
What are friends for?
That's bizarre.
What?
Someone dug up your grave.
We get bodies dug up more often than you'd think.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Grave robbers aren't just grave robbers anymore.
No, they aren't.
Oh, no, it's not just about greed anymore. It's become more personal. I had one woman trying to renew her wedding vows with her dead husband. Asked me he was better off dirt napping.
I bet.
And you get your psychos who do special stuff to the bodies you just don't want to know about, unless you want to know about it.
No, thanks, Papas.
Just as well. We don't like to talk about it. It's bad for business. That's why I called you folks instead of the police. I figured that, you keep the grave, you pay for the grave upkeep. Why don't we keep it in the family?
Oh, we appreciate that.
You do know there's no body in the casket.
Well, yes, yes. The dearly departed was,
lost at sea.
It lost at sea. The burial was merely a memorial.
Yeah, well, the 21-gun salute was a little sloppy. He must have been really upset shooting a whole clip of 9mm shells into the casket. It's weird, huh? I never had a coffin killer before.
Well, it looks like you can't rest in peace while you're alive or while you're dead. Must be the full moon.
Yeah. Amazing what kids will do for kicks, huh? Buried once. Get you guys back in the van.
Okay, Scandal. We take it from here.
Yeah, you better hurry. You don't want to miss your plane.
I'll tell Don Ho you said hi.
You mean aloha.
I mean aloha.
Aloha!
Just got the strangest phone call, Dallas.
Hey, you're two for two.
The travel agent called. Scandal never got on the plane.
Flight left 2 hours ago.
Did he seem overly upset to you when he was accessing on the computer before he left?
Hauser. Carlton Hauser.
About friendships, when you form one, you never think about how it'll end. I guess that's because you hope it never will, that the strongest friendships will last forever. The trouble is, that's not the way it always works out. Some friends you never lose track of, some turn their back on you, and some become your enemies.
truth is, the end of friendship really isn't funny after all.
Aloha. Well, this certainly isn't the Waikiki Hilton. What, are you visiting friends?
I'm on vacation, got it?
A man named Carlton Hauser, incarcerated for being criminally insane, picked a lock on his chain with a paperclip, killed his shrink, strangled his guard, and emptied his beret into your dug-up coffin. Hell of a way to start a vacation.
Get out of my face, Dallas.
Well, which one? I got a feeling I'm looking at the new one, still dealing with the old. Now, you want to tell your old friend what the hell's going on?
It's personal.
Scandal. You know tenacity is one of my virtues. And you are going to tell me what's going on, or I'm going to hound you till I find out.
My dad used to say that there was an ugly little gnome locked inside of everyone, urging us to give in to our worst impulses. I had seen the gnome's footprints in the minefields. I had seen the results of his evil work on the fragile bodies of starving victims. But I had never seen the gnome face to face. Until one day I stared at my friend Carlton Hauser's eyes, and the gnome glared back.
How's it going, Pike?
How's it?
You got your dream, huh, buddy?
Get out!
You always said you'd go fishing for life once we got out of the desert.
Shot my car.
What?
Shot my car, makes fun of my tires, and shoots my car. The man has no respect for personal property. What the hell is he trying to keep us out of?
Let me show you something.
Pike? Pike!
Hi there, this is Andy Grimes, Bay City Dive Charters. Look, a guy by the name of Mel Cooley offered me a great deal on your regulators, only I lost his card and can't remember what his shop was called. Can you help me out? Sure, I can hold.
Watch your taillights, Danny. He's been known to shoot unarmed vehicles.
I gotta get a better lock.
We know about Pike. A witness spotted a red Cobra speeding away from the scene. Care to talk about it?
I would, but I'm listening to music.
But now you're listening to us.
According to the naval record scandal, this Hauser has quite an intriguing past.
Tell you what, we walk you down memory lane, you just point out the potholes. Hauser had quite a brilliant military record, sailed through Annapolis, was pegged for a SEAL command, was considered one of the finest tacticians the Navy'd ever seen.
Seems he had a boyhood friend who did all of the above right along with him. They met in Wilderness Scouts.
So where do you keep your merit badge of scandal? Something else a little funny. Your Huck Finn Tom Sawyer story ends with Desert Storm, a little action called Black Star. I got a list of 22 names. Yours is on it, Hauser's on it, so is Pike's. Then it suddenly disappears under an electronic sand dune so deep, not even my computers can dig through.
You want to shut the door on your way out?
Hauser was your best friend. You don't have to pretend this doesn't hurt.
Save your psycho babble for the needy, huh? You do? Great. What's the address? Good. Thanks.
Oh, come on, Scandal, wait.
What do you want from me?
Well, how about the friend who used to make fun of my ties?
Well, he doesn't feel very funny. He'd like to be alone, okay?
Look, whatever's going on between you and Hauser, it's leaving behind a trail of bodies. We just can't sit back and ignore that.
You trust me?
What kind of a question is that?
Do you trust me?
Yes.
Then leave it alone.
How does a man's best friend become the boogeyman in his worst nightmare?
I don't know. But Uncle Sam's hiding a deep, dark secret, and I'm gonna go kick the crap out of some of my DC chums and find out what it is.
Lieutenant Jackson! Something's wrong! We should turn back!
No, we're not going back without Hauser.
Snoggers are dead, sir. What are we gonna do, Jackson?
It's a minefield! Hauser's pulled us into one of his traps!
Oh! Incoming!
This black star is turning blood red, sir! Fast!
What are we gonna do, Jackson? We got casualties, lots of them!
Jackson! Jackson! Jackson!
Tanks are filled and all the weight belts are calibrated for the next charter, all right?
You always worry fishing.
I know you.
You should. We served in the Navy together 4 years. Scandal Jackson.
Look, pal, I don't know what kind of scam you're trying to pull, but Scandal Jackson is dead. Believe me, it's no great loss.
Still wear your socks inside out?
Since the fifth grade. Everybody who knows me knows that.
You know about Black Star?
Who the hell are you?
Remember when the CPO showed us both what a bandit can do when you don't respect your equipment?
Oh, man. I thought you were dead. What happened? Did the plastic surgeon catch you in bed with his wife?
You catch a bullet in the face and see what it does to your complexion.
Yeah, I heard it blew your brains out. Guess we weren't that lucky, huh? What do you want?
Hauser escaped.
Well, you better just crawl back into your coffin, because if he finds you, there won't be enough left of your face to make a new one.
He killed Pike. He'll come after you, too.
Hey, it wasn't my fault your neat surgical strike turned into a bloody amputation. I was just following orders. Your orders.
Listen to me.
Sorry, pal.
You gotta listen.
Jackson, we are a couple of dead men.
I knew you were alive, Scandal.
You're dreaming, Jackson.
I took him once, I'll take him again. Look, you gotta let me take you in. I know some people who can protect you.
Just like Durham Blackstar? Forget it.
You gotta listen to me, Cooley.
Yeah, right. Last time I did that, I lost a lot of my best friends.
There's no way out.
Time to play.
Progress?
The trouble with sticking your hands in a hornet's nest is, in all probability, you're gonna get stung.
What'd you find out?
My DOD buddies just came with a straight skinny on Black Star.
Okay, let's hear it.
All right, it's interesting reading. But it's the last chapter that's the most compelling. It's the one where Scandal kills Hauser's wife. Thanks, Doc. We'll be right over.
How is he?
Doc said it was just a flesh wound, but he's lucky to be alive.
Actually, it's not his physical health I'm worried about.
Yeah, you and me both.
I have to get through all this.
Never mind that. I'll just give you the book on tape version.
Good.
When he and Scandal were in Desert Storm, Carlton Hauser snapped.
Snapped? How?
Joined up with the Iraqis and blew hell out of a U.S. Army base near Riyadh.
Riyadh? I never heard of any fighting in Saudi Arabia.
Well, you never will. Army chalked the deaths up to a freak accident.
Deaths?
Hauser's raid killed a lot of our boys.
Oh, no wonder this hurts Scandal so much. His best friend sold out to the enemy.
Hauser became the enemy. So DOD put together a covert unit of SEALs to bring Hauser out.
Operation Black Star, headed by Robert Scandal Jackson Jr.
Yes, ma'am. But it got ugly. See, Hauser's military specialty was terror tactics. You booby-trap an area, lure a group of soldiers in. Then he starts setting off his mines and remote-controlled devices all around him. Literally, they'd be terrified in his little death zone. Only after he'd seen that they'd suffered enough, we'd go in and kill him.
And he did this to Blackstar?
Lured him right into his trap. Scandal let in 22 men to bring Hauser out.
Which they obviously did.
In the end, Blackstar got Hauser. Only Scandal, Cooley, and Pike lived to talk about it. If the pain of losing most of his men wasn't hard enough on Scandal, Hauser then accused him of murdering his wife during the mission. Well, she charged at him with a gun. It was clear-cut self-defense.
And they cleared Scandal's name?
Yeah, but not his conscience. After seeing the effect Hauser's had on a friend with the flesh wound, I swear, I'm thinking maybe the lucky ones are the guys who died back there in those minefields.
Friends of yours?
Yeah.
Maybe you can talk to him. I've given him two sedatives, but I can't keep him down.
Yeah, we'll take it from here, Doc.
I gotta go.
Scandal, come on. You're lucky to be alive.
Lucky had nothing to do with it. Hauser hit me right where he wanted to.
He's got you in his minefield, and now he's making you suffer until it's time to die.
We know all about Black Star.
Then you know why I have to hunt him down.
Oh, easy, big fella. Doctor didn't release you.
I'm releasing myself. No lectures.
Scandal, this morning you asked us to trust you. We did, and we do. But trust works both ways.
Hauser's my problem, okay?
No, not okay. We're friends here, and real friends stick together. Got it?
Listen.
No, you listen. We're gonna do this together. Got it?
Got it. I found this Black Star hanging at Pike's. Looks and feels like this was made in the Middle East.
I'll just run this over to HQ. I'll have the lab boys do a rust trace on the silk. And we'll run the license plate you took off Hauser's getaway car.
Scandal, I can't pretend to know what it's like to be in a war. I can only guess at what you've been through. But I know I would have done whatever I had to do to survive.
Great, I survived. A lot of good that does with 19 families of the men who didn't.
It wasn't your fault.
Yeah, it was. I let him lure me into his village, into his trap. I should have seen it.
How? Hauser was a tactical expert.
I didn't see it because my judgment was clouded. I wasn't there to bring down an enemy. I was there to get even with a friend who betrayed me.
You did everything you could at the time. It was war.
And my men deserve better.
You don't need their forgiveness. Just your own.
Imported double weave silk.
Iraqi.
Smuggled past the blockade, I might add.
Iraqi, huh? It's no accident.
Sure not. All right. Now, that particular weave of silk is found at only one place in town, the west side, a block from the bay, and only three blocks from where that car you saw him in was stolen.
Sounds like our man likes the water.
I did a check on all the hotels in this particular sector. Unfortunately, none of them had any Carlton Hauser as a registered guest.
Why don't you try under the name of Jamed Kwawi, his adopted Iraqi name?
Good idea.
Two points, big ones. Jamad Kwawi, room 2123 at the Pavilion Terrace Hotel.
Just another one of his minefields.
You mean he wants us to find him?
Or he wouldn't have left a trail. We know how each other thinks.
Yeah, but he doesn't know me or what's ticking up here. We can take him, Scandal. You and me.
Ana Shavi Bejiak. Or for those not so well versed in the mother tongue, it's nice of you to come.
Electronic eye trigger.
Whichever was peaceful.
Man loves his games.
We've come a long way together, Scandal.
Ooh.
From the wilderness scout.
This SOB is good. Insane, but good.
Have a look.
Yeah, too damn good.
Sometimes the last leg of the journey is the toughest. At least it will be for you. I'm quite sure of that. Have a look. She's very attractive, Scandal. Brains, warmth, empathy.
Call Danny.
Not the woman my wife was. But then soon they'll be like sisters. Sisters of death.
Come on.
Pain begets pain, my friend. Remember me.
Come on.
Danielle.
Anna Shari Bebeshiak.
Anna Shari Bebeshiak.
Your merit badge?
He's in July 4th.
What's that supposed to mean?
We were in wilderness scouts together. That's where we earned our merit badges.
Good, good. All right. So we know the playing field. The trouble is, if we go in there with all the force we can muster, police, sheriffs, rangers, all that's going to be left is 1,000 acres of ash and Danielle's corpse.
I can take him.
We can take him.
Okay. If anything happens, there's something you should know.
What's that?
It's the worst tie you've ever worn.
Hey,
Wouldn't it be easier just to pull the trigger and get this over with?
I'm not going to kill you. Scandal is.
This won't bring your wife back.
No, it won't.
Scandal's not responsible for what happened.
Who is?
You are.
Scandal put a bullet in her.
You put her in the line of fire, you might as well have shot her yourself.
Scandal didn't have to come for me. He volunteered to take me down.
We all make choices. Yours killed your wife.
I spent a lot of time getting ready for this day. Your help, especially your psychological insight, will be very helpful. No matter which way he comes in, it won't be quick.
Smoking.
just to pull the trigger and get this over with?
I'm not gonna kill you. Scandalous.
This won't bring your wife back.
No, it won't.
Scandal's not responsible for what happened.
Who is?
You are.
It's a trick.
What?
No plane!
Shop. You go get him. I'll take care of Danny. Don't you worry, I'm gonna get you out of there. I don't pass out first.
Scandal.
This is where our friendship ends.
Are you okay?
Yeah. How you guys doing?
Take more than a slug in the hindquarters to keep this old frisbee down.
Hey, thank you. Both of you.
What are friends for?
While it's true friendships begin and friendships end, it's important to savor the friendship itself. The renewal, the strengthening that always takes place. Accepting the bad, embracing the good, moving forward together. But maybe the best part about friendship is starting a new one.